Okay, hello guys. Thank you so much for watching. Very excited again about today's message. Thank you so much for being a part of this. Thank you so much for supporting this ministry. And I really hope all of these messages and all of this information really helps you guys to build your faith, which is what we're going to do today. And more important than anything, build your walk and your relationship with God so that He can introduce you to your authentic self. So today we're going to speak about faith, and I want to title this message "The Opposite of Faith," or "What is the Opposite of Faith?" Because I believe to really understand what faith is, we really have to know what it's not. Because a lot of times in the Bible, you know, Jesus actually rebukes people for not having faith or for having a lack of faith. So before you get nervous, I'm going to explain what it is today, because you know, faith ultimately, at the end of the day, is not how strong our faith is or how big our faith is, because the Bible speaks about faith as a mustard seed, right? But the importance is in who our faith is. So our faith can be big, but if it's not in Jesus Christ and His finished work, our faith is worth nothing. Because faith, we have to understand this, faith is really just belief. And we're going to speak about what faith is today. And there's a difference between having faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Because having faith says, I believe this is going to happen. Having faith in self means, I believe I can make this happen. But having faith in the Lord Jesus Christ means, I believe He is going to make this happen. And I want to encourage you guys today to have that kind of faith. So, you know, I've been in many situations where people said, you know, it didn't come through. Maybe my faith wasn't strong enough. So what people do and the mistake people make is they put their faith in their faith. And they ask the question, how strong is my faith? How big is my faith? Or how hard do I believe? And I want to tell you today, it's not how big your faith is. It's about in who your faith is. If we look at Peter walking on the water, Jesus actually said to him, "Oh, you of little faith." Now, that little faith means short-term faith. So He didn't say your faith was small. He said your faith was short-term. Why was it short-term? Because He took His eyes off Jesus. And here's the thing we have to realize. We cannot walk on water, whether there are storms or not. You know, you can say today, you know, I'm fearful because of what's happening in the world right now. There's a lot of storms. I'm struggling to survive because there's a lot of storms. And I want to tell you, you cannot survive by yourself even if everything is good and even if everything is calm. You need to keep your eyes upon Jesus. So my encouragement in this area is not how big your faith is, but in who your faith is. So here's my question. Is your faith in your faith or is your faith in Jesus Christ? Look at what the Bible says in Hebrews 11. Let's go to verse 6. And this is a very well-known passage of scripture, but I'm going to take another turn with it today to explain to you guys really what this thing called faith is. The Bible says, "But without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He's a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him." So most people get the first part right. They believe that God is. Most Christians, or all Christians, in fact, get this right. They believe that God is. But where we struggle sometimes is, do we believe that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him? So, interesting about this verse, it doesn't say He's a rewarder of those who diligently has faith. He says He's a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. So, the faith that He's talking about is faith in seeking Jesus Christ, is faith in Christ, not just faith that you believe it's going to happen, not faith that you believe you can make it happen, but faith that you can believe He is going to make it happen. That's what faith is. Because the word faith, there is the Greek word pistis, which means to be persuaded or a persuasion. So here's the question, are we persuading God or is He persuading us? Obviously, He's persuading us. He's the initiator. That's why the Bible says, I've been fully persuaded. So what happens when you spend time with God? He's going to give you a dream. He's going to give you a vision. He's going to talk to you, but He's going to persuade you that this is the truth. So having faith is just saying, I believe that what God said, or I believe what God persuaded in me, or the revelation or the vision that He gave me, I believe this is true. So the Bible says in verse 1, Hebrews 11 verse 1, now faith is the substance of the things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So let me explain it this way. If you have a glass of water and you want this water to become ice, what do? You put it in the refrigerator, right? So the refrigerator is the substance that caused that causes the water to become ice. Just like that, faith is the substance that brings the things that you hope for into reality. So if you're hoping for something, if you have a vision for something, or if we look at the real meaning of faith, if the Lord Jesus has persuaded you to believe for something, you put that in faith. Now, remember what I said. I said this is faith in Christ. So you put that in Christ. You seek Christ in the situation. If you put it in Christ, what you hope for will then become a reality. So what is the opposite of faith? You know, and I've studied this, and this is the revelation that God has given me. And I've heard some theologians agree on this, that the opposite of faith is sight. Now listen what the Bible says in John 20 verse 29. Jesus said to him, Thomas, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen me, and they believed. So here he's saying, a lot of people say seeing is believing, or I will believe it if I see it. Yet Jesus comes and he says real faith is if you don't see it, but you go on persuasion. Because God has persuaded me, because the word says it, I believe it's true, even if I cannot see it. I cannot see, maybe for instance, and I'm using an example, I maybe cannot see there's money in my bank balance, but the Bible says that I'm blessed. The Bible says the blessing of the Lord makes one rich. The Bible says in Genesis 22 that God wants us to be prosperous. So I'm now persuaded by the Spirit of God according to the Word of God. So what I see is not what I focus on. What I believe in, what I believe God told me and what I believe the Word says, that's what I'm focused on. Now, if I'm focused on my reality, I'm not living in faith. If I'm focused on the person of Jesus Christ and what he promised me, even if I cannot see it in the natural, that is real faith. And I want to encourage you guys today to have real faith, to start believing that what God says and what his word says is true, and that you shouldn't believe in what you see the whole time and what you experience with your five senses. Because let's be honest, what we are experiencing with our five senses that's going on in the world right now will never get us into faith. But if we look at the Word of God, and if we are in the presence of God, and if we are persuaded by God, then we start to believe in the things that we don't see yet. And the things that we don't see yet will then start to become a reality. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 7, the Bible says, for we live by faith and not by sight. So he says we cannot live in both. We live either by faith or we live by sight. Now, not living by sight, I'm not saying deny what's going on, right? That won't be clever. That won't be smart. That won't be real. I'm saying admit what's going on. Say yes. You know, David said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Right? So we can say yes, things that are going on in the world right now or in my life right now, the things are real. But I have a belief system that Jesus Christ is going to step in and make everything good again because I put my faith in him. I'm not believing it's going to accidentally happen. I'm not believing I'm going to make it happen, although I need to obey him, yes, and I have to pray, yes, and I have to trust God, pray. But at the end of the day, I believe he is going to make it happen. So listen to what Napoleon Hill said when he spoke about autosuggestion. He said, autosuggestion is the agency of control where an individual may voluntarily feed the subconscious mind through a creative nature. So how do you feed the subconscious mind by a creative nature? Creative nature is imagination. The thing is, if you think about being creative or having a creative imagination, you might think, but is that in the Bible? Yes, if you look in Genesis, the Bible says God created. He's a creator. And I can promise you, before God spoke the whole universe into being, he imagined what it would look like. So Napoleon Hill further said, by neglect By neglect of putting thoughts in through a creative nature, you permit thoughts of destructive nature to find their way into the subconscious mind. So, through your five senses, through looking at reality the whole time, through focusing on all the bad that's going on in the world the whole time, you are putting bad thoughts in your subconscious mind. Now, also the thing that auto-suggestion shows us is that your brain, and scientists have proven this, your brain doesn't know the difference between reality and imagination. Meaning, if you imagine something, or let's say if you have faith in what you don't see, your brain believes it's the truth. He will start sending signals to your body, and your body will start creating it. That's why the Bible says, by faith we create, by faith we enter. By faith we create the future and the vision and the dream God wants us to have by faith. Now, what is faith? Faith is not focusing on what you see, but faith is having this creative imagination that what God said will actually happen and will come to pass. That is what real faith is. This means your reality and your imagination influences your mind. And by that, I'm saying this again, I'm not saying deny reality. What I am saying is imagine that what God says is true. Because if you have faith, if you believe that what God persuaded you is true, then you will create that. That's why the devil is working so hard to get you into a negative mindset. That's why the devil is working so hard to get you into a negative imagination. Because if he can get you into a negative imagination, you will start to create it. The Bible says the enemy even comes and he displays himself as an angel of light. So sometimes the devil will bring condemnation, he will bring guilt, and he will even tell you that it's God and it's not. Because the Bible says the enemy comes to kill, to steal, and to destroy. I came to bring life. Jesus says, I came to bring life and life more abundantly. So we don't have to be confused between what is the enemy and what is God. We just have to ask ourselves, does it have to do with killing, stealing, and destruction? If it's got to do with killing, stealing, and destruction, it's the enemy. If it's got to do with life and life more abundantly, it's God. And the Lord Jesus Christ wants to live you a life of abundance. Firstly, in your spiritual life, in your emotional life, in your physical health, and in your financial life. But we have to get our faith, we have to get our mindset, or I want to say this again, we have to get our imagination in line with what God said or with what he persuaded us to do. So because the subconscious mind has immense potential, we have to look into it and explore the importance of it. Did you know that science actually says that 90% of our lives are ruled or driven by the subconscious mind? Now, the subconscious mind gets built by what you put in your senses, what you imagine. So if we put the word of God in our senses the whole time, if we imagine that what God says will actually happen, our subconscious mind will start to believe it, and we will actually through our lives start to create it. And through faith, we will build and we will do what God wants us to do. And this is just to show you, this is why the enemy is working so hard to pollute your mind and to get you into a negative mindset all the time. If we look at Numbers, the book of Numbers and Numbers 13, Numbers 14, if we look at those passages, we see the story of the 12 spies. And we know the story very well, but you know, the Bible says 10 spies brought back an evil report. And you know, if we think about this 10 spies, we actually think about bad, evil people. But if you really go study the scripture, the 10 spies literally just said what they saw. And God said, no, that's an evil report. Joshua and Caleb, on the other hand, they didn't see what they saw. They said what Canaan potentially could become. So they said, listen, we see a land flowing with milk and honey. And you know, what they saw in Canaan wasn't milk and honey. They maybe saw a cow and a bee. But because they saw a cow and a bee, they saw the potential for milk and honey. And they said, you know, the reality is there are giants in the lands, but our focus, our imagination is that this can be a land of milk and honey. And at that time, really, Canaan at that time was not a good place. Canaan at that time really had a lot of giants. So actually the 10 just said what they saw. And God said it's an evil report. Why? because he doesn't want us to live by sight. He wants us to live by faith. And I want to encourage everybody that's watching today, everybody that's experiencing trouble, and that's many, many people today, because the world is in chaos, but the world is not going to be changed by born-again believers that speak what they see, that say what they see, and that believes what they see. The world is going to be changed by believers who believes that God can do a miracle. The world is going to be changed by believers who believes that God can do something great, and they can imagine something better. They can believe for something better. Why? Because according to this auto suggestion, your subconscious mind is going to start to believe it. It's going to become a habit, and then we are going to create it. Ephesians 1 verse 18 in the Passion Translation, the Bible says, I pray that the light of God will illuminate the eyes of your imagination. There we see that word imagination again. God wants to illuminate your imagination, flooding you with light until you experience, right? So he says our imagination will eventually lead to our experience, the full revelation of hope of his calling. That is the wealth of God's glorious inheritance that he finds in us, the holy ones. So what the Bible is saying here is that what we imagine will eventually create our experiences and bring what we hope for into reality. That's why I'm very careful about what I allow into my senses. That's why I'm very careful to spend time with negative people or people who just articulate what's going on in the world, right? You can mention what's going on in the world for a few seconds, but then for the remaining of the time, I want you to speak about how God is going to do something great, because that's what the Bible is full of. So the opposite of faith, according to these scriptures, is sight. And faith is seeing what God sees. Faith is imagining what God imagines. And faith is believing what God says, and not staying so focused on what's happening in the natural. I believe if we can put our faith, not in that something accidentally will happen, not in that we can supernaturally make things happen, but if we put our faith in Jesus Christ, if we seek him, if we pursue him, if we believe what he says, if we imagine what he imagines, God can use us to bring so much great change in the world and even in our personal lives. This is why the Bible says people in the Bible prospered and did well in times of famine. Why? Because they believed that what God said was actually true. I hope this helped you, and I know it will help you if you go apply it. Check what you put in your senses. Check what you put in your imagination. Put the Word of God in. Imagine that what God says is actually true, and see how your life changes. From the Healthy Owners team, we love you. God bless you. See you soon. Goodbye.